Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. So today our topic is AC bridges, which is a part and parcel of the subject, that is electronic measurements and instrumentation. If you are new to my channel, please do subscribe our channel for more videos. So let's move further. So it is the introduction of AC bridges. So I had already discussed the DC bridges. So if you don't see the DC bridges video, so the link will be given in the description. You have to go through that particular link. Fine. So let's see the introduction of AC bridges first. So all AC bridges are based on Wheaton bridge. So Wheaton bridge is also one of the DC bridge. Fine. So in AC bridge, so the AC bridge circuit consists of the four arms having four impedances. So, and also AC bridge circuit also consists of a detector, and also AC bridge circuit consists of AC voltage source. It is AC bridge, no? That's why it consists of AC voltage source. So, in case of a DC bridge, yeah, we have the four arms. Similarly, we have the galvanometer, and similarly, we have the DC voltage source. So, in case of a AC bridge, you have the detector and AC voltage source. In case of a DC bridge, you have galvanometer and a DC voltage source. So the condition for the bridge balancing in the AC bridges, in case of the AC bridges, is the Z1 Z4 is equal to Z2 Z3. So it is the condition of the AC bridge balancing condition. So it is simply remember as opposite arm resistance multiplication. So opposite arm resistance multiplication is nothing but Z1 Z4 equal to Z2 Z3. Fine. So, if you wanted to write this bridge balanced equation in case of admittances, so it will be modified as Y1, Y4 equal to Y2, Y3. So, it is in case of admittances. In the form of admittances, it is the bridge balanced condition. So, similarly, in case of DC bridges, the bridge balancing condition is R equal to P by Q into S. So, it is the bridge balancing condition in case of DC bridges. So next one, in AC bridges, the phase angle condition is also there. Phase angle condition is Z1 into Z4 angle of theta 1 plus theta 4. C is equal to Z2 into Z3 angle of theta 2 plus theta 3. So it is a phase angle condition in case of AC bridges. Okay guys, so let's move further. So these are the different types of the AC bridges. We have the Schrödinger bridge, Wien bridge, Maxwell inductance bridge, Maxwell inductance and capacitance bridge, Hayes and Anderson bridge. So all these Schrödinger, Wien, Maxwell, Hayes and Anderson, all these are scientist names only. There is nothing special in that. Fine. So actually the Schrödinger bridge used to find out the unknown capacitance. Wien bridge used to find out unknown frequency. Whereas Maxwell inductance bridge is used to find out the unknown inductance. Okay, unknown inductance with the help of the known inductance. With the help of the known inductance, we can measure the unknown inductance in case of a Maxwell inductance bridge. So, in case of a Maxwell inductance and capacitance bridge, we have to measure the unknown inductance with the help of the known capacitance. And Hayes and Anderson bridge also used to measure the unknown inductances. Okay. So, in this particular session, I am going to discuss these three bridges: Schrödinger bridge, Wien bridge, and Maxwell inductance bridge. So, in the second part, I will discuss these Maxwell inductance capacitance bridge, Hayes and Anderson bridge. Okay, so the first one, circuit diagram of a Schrödinger bridge is like this. So actually, initially I had said no, AC is the circuit consists of the four arms having four impedances. So it consists of detector and AC voltage source. Okay. So see here guys, so it is the detector, so it is the AC voltage source. The potential across this AC voltage source is E. It consists of four arms, AB, BC, CD, DA. All these are the four arms. A, B, C, D are the different four nodes. Okay. So, arm AB, the potential across arm AB is E1. Potential across arm BC is E3. Potential across arm AD is E2. Potential across arm CD is E4. Okay. So, it is the Z1. So, Z1 is the impedance across this arm AB. So, Z2 is the impedance across this arm AD, and Z4 is the impedance across arm CD, and Z3 is the impedance across BC. I1 current flow through this particular arm, I2 current flow through this particular AD arm, so I4 current flows through this particular CD arm and I3 current is flowing through BC arm. So initially what we have to do is for analysis, the analysis of all AC bridges is almost same. So initially we have to find out the impedances equation Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. After that, you have to substitute in the bridge balancing condition. That is Z1, Z4 equal to Z2, Z3. You have to substitute in this particular equation. So after that, after substituting the values, you have to compare the, you have to separate the real part and imaginary part. You have to compare them and finally, you have to find out the required values. So it is the analysis. So it is analysis procedure. So, in steering bridge actually it is used to measure the unknown capacitance, no? So, in this particular diagram, we have to find out the C1 and R1. So, actually I am written as C1 and R1. So, if you don't like these values, so we can replace with the CX and RX. Our main wish is to find out the C1 and R1. Okay. So, initially we have to obtain the equation for the Z1, Z2, Z3 and Z4. So, see here guys, the Z1 equation. So, this C1 and R1 both are connected in series, no? It can be written as R1 plus XC1. So, already simply guys, XC means 1 by J omega. You have to remember these two equations. XL equal to J omega. Inductive reactance and capacitive reactance. So, okay, Z1 equation is R1 plus XC1. So, it can be written as Z1 equal to R1 plus 1 by J omega C1. It is a Z1 equation. You can obtain the Z1 equation like this. Next, Z2 equal only capacitor C2 is there, no? That means Z2 equal to XC2. That means 1 by J omega C2. That is the Z2 equation. Next, Z3 equation. Z3 is only one resistor is there. It is the Z3 equation. So, after that, Z4 equation. See here guys, these both, this capacitor and this resistor are connected in parallel like this. It is the C4 and R4, it is the Z4. So, it can be written as 1 by, both are connected in parallel, no? That means 1 by Z4 is equal to 1 by R4 plus 1 by XC4. It is the 4th equation. From this, we can find out, we can obtain the Z1, Z2, Z3 and Z4 values. After that, we have to substitute in this particular equation. See here guys. So, we have obtained the Z1 equation. Z2 equation, Z3 equation, similarly we have obtained the Z4 equation. See here guys, and obtained the 1 by Z4 equation, if you reverse it, we can obtain the Z4 equation as R4 by 1 plus J omega C4 into R4. Fine. After that, you have to substitute all these values. So, simply you have to multiply. So, after that, you have to calculate, so it is simple mathematics. So, after that, you have to compare the real part and imaginary part. So, observe here, in this particular equation, so, the real part, that means the terms which don't contain J term, are the real part, the terms which contain J term, so, the, call it the imaginary part. Okay. So, here, R1, R4, so, and C4 into R3 into R4 by C2, these two are the real parts. You have to compare both the, after that you have to obtain the R1 value. Okay, so this R1 value you have to obtain. So after that you have to compare the imaginary parts. Minus J into R4 by omega C1, minus J into R3 by omega C2, omega omega gets cancelled, minus J gets cancelled. We are left over with R4 by C1 equal to R3 by C2. Which means we have to obtain the C1, no? C1 is equal to R4 by R3 into C2. It is the C1 equation. Fine. So, we have to find out this C1 and R1. Fine. Next one, Wien bridge. So, initially I had said, Wien bridge is used to find out the unknown frequency. Okay. It is the circuit diagram of the Wien bridge. So, it also consists of one detector and one AC voltage source. Potential across this source is E. So, potential across this arm is E1. Potential across BC is E3. Potential across AD arm is E2 and potential across CD arm is E4. Fine. So, Z1 is the impedance across arm AB and Z2 is the impedance across arm AD. So Z3 is the impedance across arm BC and Z4 is the impedance across arm CD. So initially I am going to apply the equation for the Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. Same analysis, same procedure you have to follow in case of a AC brace. So Z1 equation. So see here guys, this is C1 and R1 connected in parallel. So that means you have to write down the equation like this. 1 by Z1 is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by XC1. Okay, it is the equation 1. In case of XC1, you have to substitute. So 1 by Z1 is equal to 1 by R1 plus J omega C. It is the 1 by Z1 equation. So that means next Z2 equation. The R2 and C2 connected in parallel, connected in series now, it can be written as R2 plus 1 by J omega C. So it is the Z2 equation. Similarly, Z3. Z3 consists of only resistor R is the Z3 equation. Next is Z4. See here guys, Z4 consists of only resistor R. So these are the 4 equations. Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. So after that, see here the Z1 equation. So initially I have obtained 1 by Z1 equation. So if you take the LCM, if you invert it, we can get a Z1 equation is R1 by 1 plus J omega C1 into R1. Similarly, Z3 R3, Z4 R4 and Z2 R2 plus 1 by J omega 2. Fine. So after that, similar manner, we have to substitute in this particular bridge balanced condition. Z1, Z4 equal to Z2. After that, it is a simple mathematics. So we have to R4 by R3. So after that, you have to invert if this term goes to this side, this term will go into the invert. So after that, simple mathematics, after that, you have to cancel it. So after that, you have to compare the real part and the imaginary part. Finally, so this is the final equation. From this equation, you have to compare the real part and imaginary parts. So real part R4 by R3 is equal to real part is R2 by R1. Another real part is C1 by C2. So these both terms consist of J terms. No? So these are the imaginary parts. Compare the real parts and imaginary parts separately. Okay. So after that, we can get in. So what we have to obtain by using Wien bridge frequency? We have to obtain the frequency. That's our aim. So after that, if you compare the imaginary parts, we can get the omega square equal to 1 by C1 into C2 into R1 into R2. We have to obtain omega equal to 1 by square root of R1 R2 C1 C2, which is the in terms of a radians per second. It is also frequency. If you want to convert in hertz, we have to replace omega with 2 pi. After that, F value is equal to 1 by 2 pi into square root of R1 R2 into C1 C2. We simply replace R1 R2 equal to R, C1 C2 equal to C. We can obtain the frequency of Wien bridge is F equal to 1 by 2 pi R is the frequency of the Wien bridge. That's it. So next one, Maxwell inductance bridge. This is also same procedure we have to follow. Same thing, so 4 potential across 4 arms. So it is the Z1 is the potential across this arm, so Z2 potential across this arm, Z4 potential across this arm, and Z3 is the potential across this arm. As it's of one detector and one AC voltage source. Similarly, you have to find out the equation, Z1 equation. So Z1 equation is Rx. So both are connected in series now. That means Z1 is equal to Rx plus XLX. That means Z1 is equal to Rx plus J omega Lx. So it is the equation 1. So we have to obtain the Z2 equation. Z2 equation is R2 plus J omega L2. So actually it consists of this inductor will consist of internal resistance is small r. So that means the Z2 equation will be modified as Z2 plus J omega L2 plus internal resistance R2. Okay, this is a simple modification in case of a only Maxwell inductance bridge. This is very, very important, okay? You have to add the internal resistance. So next one, Z3 simply consists of R3. So next one, Z4 is R4. Okay. So see here guys, Z4 is R4, Z2 is, we have to, compulsory, we have to add the internal resistance for this particular arm AD. After that, we had already known the bridge balanced equation. That is Z1, Z4 equal to Z2, Z3. simply we had already obtained z1 value, z4 value, z2 value, z3 value. Simply you have to substitute 1 through 3, 4 equations in this particular equation. If you substitute and if you have to multiply, after that you have to compare. The real part is rx r4 is equal to r2 r3 plus a small r2 into r3. If you compare, we can get the unknown resistance rx value. So if you compare the imaginary parts, if you compare the real part, you can get unknown resistance value. Whereas if you compare the imaginary part, you can get the unknown capacitance value. Like that, we can obtain both RX and LX. Okay, thanks.